We've talked quite a bit about squash in previous episodes. One thing that keeps coming up though is looking at squash that potentially have hybridized. Basically, we have a squash that has been crossed between two different parents. So what most likely happened is we had some seed that was collected from a home garden. We pulled the seeds out of that squash, we washed it, we dried them, we stored them properly, then we planted them this spring. Then lo and behold, during the growing season, we ended up with something we totally were not expecting. If you want to make sure that you avoid this similar situation, you probably want to make sure that you're buying from a quality nursery or seed source where you know that that seed is going to be true to the variety. If you're growing squash at home and you're collecting that seed, you just need to understand that there's a risk that you're going to end up with something you weren't anticipating and that it could cross with something else totally random that might be in somebody else's yard. The last thing to consider is the edibility of these fruits. You need to keep in mind that some of these plants may have crossed with another plant that are not edible. If you're looking for new varieties of squash to try this growing season, check out one of your local seed libraries or contact your local extension office. From the University of Wyoming Extension, I'm Brian Sebade, and you're watching From the Ground Up.